Hello and welcome back to Lightning Gaming, everybody. So guys, recently we've been getting a lot of comments of people asking why, if they make their structures 15 blocks or higher, when zombies drop down, they still attack the structure, and mainly the part where the zombies climb up when they are in their infinite loop. So in this video, I'm gonna show you two small secrets how you can completely stop that from happening. That will just help you out a lot. Alright guys, so like you can see, I made my structure only 15 blocks high. Now for the purpose of this video, I'm gonna use a wedge 60 tap, because that's the one that most people use for an infinite loop. So yeah, for you guys that doesn't yet know about this, basically you're just gonna choose this wedge 60. You're gonna put it on the side of your block, just like this. Now guys, the best will be to make it 3 blocks long, but you can make it less or even more if you really wanted to. After you place them, you just want to fill the gap with normal blocks. And then you are going to select a half block to place on the wet 60 taps. Now this one, you do want to take 3 blocks high, just so that zombies can't stack up on each other and try and climb on it, getting to your base in that way. Okay, but that's it for the wedge 60. Now the next thing I did is I just built a structure, just an easy structure, nothing special about it, just super easy. And I'm just gonna place this for a shield, a zombie shield, so I can shoot through it and eat through it if zombies really get that close. I don't think they will, but I'm still gonna do it because it also gives you a big field of view when you're shooting. So I'm just gonna place this double pipe. Okay, and then the same block on top, it's this one again. Okay, we're just gonna take this right through. Alright guys, so now our basic structure is up. Now I can start to show you the secrets. Alright, so the first thing you wanna do is you wanna select the ramp, which is this block right over here. Now guys, you want to place it on the second block from the ground, just this way. I'm gonna show you in a little bit why we are actually placing these ramps. But like you can see, it's right under the point where the zombies will drop down. So the next thing we're gonna do after you place the ramps, you're just gonna go right around your structure and just dig one hole deep. Just like this, just keep going right around the structure. You're gonna do a little bit of the part where the zombies go up as well, which I'm gonna show you in a little bit. Alright, so once the hole is done, you wanna select this block right over here, which is the zombie force field. Make sure you select this one and not the other one. And you just want to place it like this, just right next to all your structures. Like you can see, I kept the one side open because that's the part where the zombies will go up. But furthermore, you're just gonna place this right around your main structure as well. Now guys, what the ramp and this will do is, when the zombies fall down, they will fall on the ramp and they will slide right past the zombie force field. In that way, when they slide, they won't rage at all, so they will just run around, continue the loop without stopping to attack anything, and without blocking each other, because that's normally when it happens, when they start to attack your structures. Alright, like you can see, I've got my zombie shield up everywhere, and now I'm just gonna add the ladders and the door, and then I will skip to Fortnite so you guys can see how well it works. How great this two secrets actually is. Like you can see, my 3 ladders are up. This is the side the zombies will go up. I've got spikes on the roof. And right here is at the back is my ladder where I will go up and down. Just remember to keep it 2 blocks off the ground so zombies can't climb up. So now guys, zombies will come, they will drop down, they will fall on this ramp. They will slide right past that first zombie shield, and then they will just start the loop all over again without even attacking any of your structures. Okay, so it's Horde Night, the zombies will start spawning in now. Now I'm just quickly gonna show you how well this actually works. By the way guys, while I'm waiting for the zombies, if you're new to the channel, please remember to subscribe and leave us a like. Okay, there they come. Like you can see, guys, they won't stop for a second. They just run right past all your structures, straight to the ladders. And here they come. There they go. I'm gonna show you in a little bit. If I go out of the building, I'm just gonna give you a better view. But like you can see, they will fall down. They won't stop for anything. They won't attack anything. They will just keep running in the exact same loop. But yeah, it works super well. And basically, if you're doing it like this way, there's literally no way the zombies will attack or destroy any of your horde base. Now I'm just gonna go to the outside and just give you a better view of what's actually going on. Alright guys, like you can see, they fall down on the ramp. And from there, they will go straight to the ground. And when they stand up, they will just repeat the loop and keep doing that without even damaging any of your structures at all. The only problem is the dogs, but if you build a sword base a little bit better and you have a good ranged weapon, you can just take them out with the weapon. But yeah guys, that's it for this video. I hope it helped, and thank you everyone for watching. Please remember to subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.